Apalachicola River and Bay are among the most productive natural systems in North America. The productivity of the Bay is important to the lives of people living in the fishing communities of Apalachicola and East Point. But what makes Apalachicola River and Bay so productive? To answer this question, we must start far north in the Blue Ridge Mountains in northeastern Georgia. Some of the water that makes its way to Apalachicola Bay gets its start from springs and creeks in North Georgia's Chattahoochee National Forest in the Blue Ridge Mountains. The Chattahoochee then passes through metro Atlanta, then turns south and forms the border between most of Georgia and Alabama. The Flint River, the other major tributary of the Apalachicola, starts just south of the Atlanta International Airport and flows south through Albany to the Florida border. Traversing most of the length of the state of Georgia, these two rivers eventually meet at Lake Seminole and form the Apalachicola. This lake is formed by a dam on the Georgia-Florida line and is the last of a series of lakes formed by dams on the Chattahoochee River, the largest of which is Lake Lanier, north of Atlanta, which provides water supply to the Atlanta population. The watershed, or land area that is drained by the Apalachicola-Chattahoochee-Flint River systems, covers almost 20,000 square miles of Georgia, Alabama, and Florida. It is one of the largest watersheds east of the Mississippi River. The Chattahoochee and Flint River basins make up almost 90% of the total watershed, so any activity that goes on in these rivers can affect the Apalachicola River and Bay. With the increase of human population, infrastructure, industry, and dramatic rise in agricultural irrigation in this region, come additional pressures to the watershed and the entire river and bay system. The population of Greater Atlanta has increased from 2.5 million in the late 1990s to over 5.5 million today and is projected to continue growing. Increased demands for fresh water for both urban and agricultural use reduce the amount of water available to feed into the Apalachicola River and Bay system. It has been shown that decreased freshwater quantity due to an increase in human activity in the watershed can upset nature's balance and dramatically alter the river and bay system. If too much water is used upstream, especially during a drought, Apalachicola Bay can become too salty, which can change the ecology of the bay. The water levels in the river can also become too low for fish and mussel populations. From the Jim Woodruff Dam, the wild and scenic Apalachicola flows free and undammed over 100 miles through the Florida Panhandle, through stands of tupelo pollinated by bees to make golden honey, through cypress swamps that turn auburn red in the fall, and past forests of longleaf pine. The river continues its journey south until its fresh water spills into Apalachicola Bay. It is Florida's largest river, with an average of over 16 billion gallons of water emptying into the bay every day. This is enough water to fill a hole the size of a football field, 7 miles deep. The water isn't clear, but muddy. However, this doesn't mean that the water is dirty. The murky appearance of the river and bay means that it is healthy and full of food. The organic matter and nutrients in the water are essential food sources for the oysters and other species in the bay. Hence, Apalachicola River's nickname, the lifeblood of the bay. But where do these nutrients come from? The answer is that trees and other plants along the river transfer energy from the sun into new growth in the form of fruits, berries, and leaves. Since the Apalachicola River is in a temperate climate, these plants seasonally shed their leaves. When they fall to the ground, decomposers, such as mushrooms and termites, break down the leaves and other debris along the forest floor into detritus. Detritus contains energy, and along with microscopic plants and animals, is the basis of food webs in both the river and bay. This is why it is important for the river to be protected, as well the land alongside it, the floodplain. The Apalachicola River floodplain is the largest in Florida. In attempting to preserve this treasure, Florida has protected hundreds of thousands of acres in their natural and pristine state. At times, especially during the rainy season, the Apalachicola River will spill over its banks into the floodplain. When the river rises, the energy-rich detritus from swamps and forests in the floodplain are picked up by the river and carried southward to the bay. Trees and other plants in the Apalachicola River floodplain deposit around 350,000 metric tons of material that is turned into detritus. That is enough to fill 25,000 dump trucks. When the water level drops, much of the floodplain dries out. This regular ebb and flow of water is essential to the health of the river and the bay. The floodplain forests are rich with an abundance and diversity of animal and plant species and have been recognized as being one of the most important wildlife habitats in the United States. Invertebrates ranging from insects to snails to crawfish provide food for many larger animals. Fish such as bass and brim swim out into the floodplains when the river is high looking for food and shelter as well as a place to lay their eggs. Many different types of snakes, lizards, turtles, and alligators can be found in the river and floodplain. This region has the highest species diversity of reptiles and amphibians in North America north of Mexico. Bald eagles soar over the river in the winter, and swallow-tailed kites hunt and nest here in the summer. This area supports a large and diverse population of both year-round and migratory bird species. A wide diversity of mammals also find food and shelter in the river floodplain. Beavers build dams along tributaries, and black bear amble through oaks and maples in the drier areas of the floodplain. Perhaps the most important wildlife function floodplains serve today is that of providing large tracts of relatively undisturbed habitat and travel corridors that are used extensively by many animal species. Along the last 10 miles of the river, as you get closer to the bay, the forested floodplain opens up and turns into marshland. Marshes are wetlands dominated by grassy plants and are among the most productive habitats in the world. Like the essential floodplain plants, marsh grasses convert the sun's energy into the food that feeds the web of life. The marsh plants also act as water filters, store carbon from the atmosphere, and provide shelter for many Apalachicola Bay species that depend on these marshes in the early stages of their life. After the 100-mile journey of meandering through the piney woods and forested floodplains of North Florida, the Apalachicola River flows through the marshes and fans out into the delta, stretching its banks as it reaches toward the bay where river meets sea. Apalachicola Bay is an estuary, an area where fresh and salt water meet and mix. This rich mixing of water supports a great diversity of life. Estuaries are known as the nurseries to the ocean because so many saltwater species start their lives in the protected, nutrient-rich confines of the bay. It is estimated that 90% of seafood harvested from the Gulf spend an essential stage of their life cycle in an estuary. The Apalachicola Bay is home to many unique communities. Seagrass beds sheltering juvenile fish, mudflats frequented by hungry herons, and oyster bars that host a wide diversity of crabs, marine worms, mollusks, fish, and shrimp. Oysters are important to the ecological health of the estuary, as well as the economic health of this community. Historically, Apalachicola Bay has produced 90% of the oysters in Florida. Healthy oyster beds are an indicator of estuarine health. Because oysters are tremendous filter feeders, the quality of the bay water determines the quality of the oysters. A single oyster can filter up to 50 gallons of water a day. Oyster reefs also provide habitat for numerous other estuarine species. Until recently, Apalachicola Bay had been one of the healthiest and productive oyster habitats in the United States. Only about 15% of the world's oyster beds are healthy and productive. 85% have been lost due to changes in water quantity, water quality, over-harvesting, and pollution. Human activities on the Chattahoochee and Flint have caused changes to the natural flow and health of the river system that feeds Apalachicola Bay. Because of the connectivity of this large system, the health and productivity of the bay are at risk. If not addressed, these threats have the potential to change permanently the extremely unique productivity of Apalachicola Bay. More likely than not, when you catch a fish or eat locally caught oysters and shrimp in Apalachicola or East Point, it spent part or all of its life in Apalachicola Bay. Another important aspect of the estuary ecosystem are the barrier islands. Apalachicola Bay is protected by a string of barrier islands that parallel the mainland coast. From west to east, they are named St. Vincent, Little or Cape St. George, St. George, and Dog Islands. Much of the habitat of these islands is within protected public lands. Barrier islands serve two primary functions for the estuary. They protect the bay from the wave action of the Gulf, and they contain a mix of salt and fresh water by allowing an exchange of water through the island passes. The Gulf of Mexico is what we call our portion of the Earth's ocean. It is the last piece of our ecologic puzzle that started in the foothills of the Blue Ridge Mountains of North Georgia. The Gulf of Mexico is essential to the health of the bay. Every day as the tides rise, salt water is pushed in through the passes, carrying with it oxygen, nutrients, and saltwater species. And as the tides fall, water from the bay rushes out through the passes to refresh and clean the bay. This continuous cycle helps to mix the water and provide the perfect conditions for estuarine animals to form and flourish. Today, the fisheries in the Gulf of Mexico are among the most productive in North America. Many species, including snapper, blue crab, and shrimp, start their lives in the estuary and return to it when it is time to spawn. A drop of water comes out of an Appalachian spring, journeys from the foothills of the Appalachians, past large cities, small towns, and rows of cotton. It flows out into floodplain forest, through coastal marshes, and into the estuary where it mixes with salt water from the Gulf. Spanning three states, the Apalachicola, Chattahoochee, and Flint River system supports a high diversity of species and is home to many endangered, threatened, and rare species, some found nowhere else on Earth. Every piece of the puzzle is essential to maintaining the health and productivity of the whole. We must take care of the entire system, from the Appalachians to the Gulf. The waters of the Apalachicola River and Bay system need to be protected and maintained so that we can pass on this treasure for future generations to enjoy. It is up to us to preserve it.